Tanya by alarm. This woman will get ready to see
it. She has got it. She has got it.
The boys, even my Kate Kitchen has a bad drive in the Southern Radio. He's actually rather charming. I feel so much better.
Us?
They're well within chaos, everyone. It's complete anarchy. Our children are their planet's only hope. Have you saw Portia's goddesses? I have forgotten who they are. We're their parents and originals.
Calm down, Titania.
Me, calm down, everyone. When was the last time you took me?
You sent them to the finest theatre school in the country. What could possibly go wrong?
Ashley.
Okay. Oh. Do you girls want to go to my party?
Sure.
Looking good, Amari. Love the glasses, girls. Scarf too.
Stop! Little guess. Portrait. Nothing.
Actually, I wrote a girl's song whilst on tour.
Really?
Yes.
No, 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 Mari.
You actually take a look at something to show you. Really? Bye, girls.
Please welcome the Upside Downs!
Thank you. going on here?
What are we? Get the tongs.
Oh dear lord, the tongs!
Okay. Oh dear lord.
I never get to use the tongs. What man?
Tom.
You can't say
to
do it, you just
call it the
ring.
Hey, what would you
do in
20 kids?
Guys,
the
Captain
Martin.
Sea levels are rising.
I think she's the most important
measure in this.
With this money, we can make our school
carbon neutral!
Or we can slide
the ring
over, split the cash, fly
our
girls
up to Paris. And get our
beauty on! Right, let's see.
Well, judging by the shapes and the markings, I'd say, yep, it's a ring.
Any idea for a look?
Yep.
Absolutely.
Oh. Look, guys, it's not about the magic ring. Right? No, what is going to fit in the vision? We're going to see it, fancy is just it.
Because,
like, you guys be so cute together.
Right, what are you?
Dark and stormy night.
and our own master Shakespeare under the cloak of darkness is seated in the corner of the tavern with a beautiful Victorian female pirate, Emmy Topham. It is believed that together they possessed a secret, a treasure beyond our comprehension, one that could only be revealed when the time was right. This treasure will bestow great power on those clever enough to locate the city of May. King James sat upon the throne, and this secret would have our beloved benefactor imprisoned, possibly even slain. And so, like all good pirates, he hid the treasure he made a map. This school, as you know, is believed to not be for mere mortals, but for those children descended from the immortalized characters of Shakespeare's creation. And it is here he hid the map.
A treasure map?
Really?
This was no ordinary map, silly. He made two rings and engraved happy information on each of them. Together, they revealed the location of the hidden treasure.
So, this is one of the rings.
That's hard to conclude that it leads us to.
A supersized special bling.
Paris.
Malibu Beach House.
Where's the remains?
A pair of diamond encrusted tongs.
A trip down under.
Deep down under.
Gucci!
Quadrants! Quadrants!
Oh my gosh! A trident!
Action stations, get the tongs.
Nobody panic. We've got this. Thank you. Wichita. Far from this opera forevermore. I'm gonna work this straw. Make the sweat drip out of every pore. And I'm breathing, and I'm breathing, and I'm breathing right before the Lord. And I will think no more. And the stain's coming from my
Thank you. are you people?
Here.
You're not the BDs, I'll take that.
Thank you. Oh, skills are getting all boys private school.
I'm right here.
But not by any means least.
Sebastian. Sebastian. De Bouillard.
I know your father.
Yes, you must. He's a very well-known man.
Oh, this is Wills.
I'm Harry.
Oh, hello!
minute, you know, I am pregnant with boy. He is coming. So I ride on back about there to go see the doctor. I'm here. Oh, look at your ring. It's so ugly. Would you like a ring? Oh, look at that. That's my gold. It's being among your students.
Where?
Never mind, that is not my gold.
Can we please get to the bottom of this?
Bottom? You are talking about my bottom?
No.
The age of deficits, eh? Oh, babushka, you Americans are so crazy.
British. You mean British?
Not America. Who are you people? You are changing me. Run, God, Mama is coming.
Once he and I have completed our part of the mission, it's up to you. Keep him focused. Bring it!
Tired. You got as cute as fish, fish. Another one in the basket.
Welcome to the Globe Theatre. The second half of Romeo and Juliet will commence in 3 minutes.
Ashley!
my heart long for now. It's where it's like, oh, I've never sort of been. What light is that? Beyond the window breaks. It's the east, the Juliet's sun.
Ah, Romeo!
Et tu, brute.
Flow, Caesar. Flow!
Ah!
Caesar, Caesar, pleasant I come. I have a mortal longing in me. Put on my robe. Fetch my crown. Shakespeare was in the top.
The bard is a vote.
Scottish word for the homies.
A woman read the Bible? We asked earlier, Queen Lear and Hidden Secrets of Will Shakespeare.
Guys,
the prince book.
Odin, Tyr, students, what you will find in this book is your true heritage. You must prepare yourself.
You bet. Shakespeare's works were no ordinary works of fiction. His characters were so alive, so true. The gods wanted their stories told, and Shakespeare was the man, or the girl, to do it. Your pens, Macbeth, Romeo, Oberon.
Queen Titania, Cleopatra. Yes, girls?
Did the gods have anything in your city? Did you what?
Wait. The world wasn't ready back then for a girl, and a rather unconventional girl to change the world. So the secrets and identities of William.
Anyway, talk. We're heading. Only to be found in the time of the drought.
So that means we're like princesses or something?
Demigods! Cool!
Demigods?
I congratulate you, madame. Your students are quite remarkable. If a little unconventional.
The secret is out. Well done, girls. This is the biggest story to come out of our country for 400 years. And to believe it happened here, in his theatre.
The lost secrets of William Shakespeare will change his country and our schools forever. You and I should probably get better acquainted. Perhaps with dinner.
Well, demigods, while waiting for the world's media to descend, CNN, Fox News,
Her Majesty, Beyonce and Jay-Z.
What could we possibly do on stage at the Globe, Amari?
Ooh. How's about a little party? This is Shakespeare's gaff after all.
Yeah!
So, would you guys like to see his dance?
Yeah!
Are you sure you can handle it?
Yeah!
Alright then.
Thank you.
Next we were moving on, he was with me. Yeah, me, said I they know what is what, but they don't know what is what. They just strut. What the?
A tiger. Don't lose no sleep. Don't need opinions from a shellfish or a sheep.
Fantastic, well done. Not too much to say, I'm going to fly through it because there are a couple of children here that would like to speak, and then you'll understand why in just a moment. So they've got a few things they'd like to say. No idea what, but they have got a few things to say. So very quickly, I would just like to say thank you to all the parent helpers who helped over the last 3 nights. So thank you all of us for doing the sound and lighting today. Obviously, before we start with the children, I wouldn't be able to do tonight without Sarah and Lindsay. Together for me, and honestly, she's there every single day, she's there in every text to help me with anything. So, thank you so much. I believe, you're not going to Sam. Hannah? Yep, no, Sam's got a different job, haven't you? Yep, you can write here, Sam. Okay, and Sarah? Someone wants to read it? No? Okay, we're just trying to get to you. No, you're okay. It's coming along. So huge thank you, Sarah. Thank you so much. I've done so much work with children individually over the last few weeks, just to help them with their accents and everything. It was just amazing what a difference it made to the show. So a massive thank you to Sarah and Lindsay. I honestly can't do it. Very first junior production that we've ever done, with purely the ones that were under 10 years old. They wanted their own play and their own chance to be on the stage, and I thought they were absolutely amazing. And I couldn't actually thank any of the little ones individually, because there's just every single one of them is a star. So can we give them a round of applause? It was the first junior production that I've written for the stage, and we've practiced at class over the last few years, it's been fantastic. But this year, because some of the children were doing a college course, they actually produced it and brought it to the stage and choreographed it, and did all the acting. So everything you saw with your juniors tonight wasn't down to me, it was really down to the production team, specifically to our two coaches, Zach and Emily, who are completely dedicated to all of your juniors. And worked really hard with them. The last 3 nights, they've worked on stage with Cara, Chloe and Orla. I'm going to actually ask Emily, who keeps shopping with me today, to come forward. They were just unbelievable and such a huge help. So thank you to every single senior that helped me with the junior staff. Now I'd like to invite forward a group of children from my Monday class who, as you probably noticed, did both productions. Now it was hard enough doing one, and on the first night we actually had three of them almost faint because they put their heart and soul into the first production. That one did faint, but the first production, and then quickly changed and straight on with no break to a second production. That's 2.5 hours of theatre for an 8-year-old, which is just incredible. And they tried so hard and they worked so, so well. So if I can ask Emily, you've got a little something, haven't you? For Niamh, Melissa, Grace, Anna, I'm actually heartbroken about. Our Benji is actually my husband's stolen. So my husband is now stolen Benji as a hairdresser. I thought Benji was going to be an actor, but no, he's going to be a hairdresser. So our Benji moved into Captain Hook tonight. I'm sure he'll come back as Captain Hook because he just loves it. But we could say a massive thank you to Benji. Now my drone not like something I'll say. Okay, so that's all the things I've got to say about the Little Junior production. It was amazing and I was so chuffed with it. But now I've just got a couple of things to say about the senior production, and I don't even know where to begin with that, because I've never seen children in the senior class work so hard and shown me so much love, especially over the last couple of weeks, so much love and so much respect to myself and to each other. They've been so supportive. The messages they send me at night just to say how hard they're going to work, or they missed something, they'll get it right the next night, and I'm saying don't panic, but just so dedicated, because that was such a complicated show, and they asked me to give them something dramatic, and we went for drama. I think that was a very dramatic play, and they really worked hard on their characters, and understanding something like Shakespeare's not easy, and they put their wee heart and soul into understanding who they were supposed to be, and what kind of child would be a descendant of Shakespeare, which was just incredible, and I thought they brought those characters to life tonight so, so well. I would like to say a very special mention to Rachel, who you saw as our head girl, because on top of doing all of this, she sat all her exams over the last month. With Russian dancing, just amazing. That parents probably aren't aware of, but we did have a major drama just about 10 days ago when one of our main characters could no longer participate in the show, and there was a bit of a panic, and this child came to the door and says to me, I've got it covered. She already had a huge part in the show, and she says to me, no, don't panic, I can do this, I can do the whole second part of the show for you, I can do the whole other character. So she played two characters tonight without any of you even realising, learned two huge parts, including that globe scene, which was so difficult. So we have something special for our Rebecca for saving the show. Alright, I do believe, is Gail actually here? Gail, hi, do you want to come up, Gail? Alright, so I don't know if any of you actually know Gail. I think a few of the parents of the seniors have met Gail before. Gail came, her son's been working with her for a while, but she got in touch at the start of the year because she works for Kelvin College, and offered the children the opportunity to sit the qualifications for the work that they're doing here, which I think is incredible. So we ran a pilot scheme, we took the children that had been working with us for a while as coaches, and we put them through the equivalent of an Act 5 qualification with ourselves, and that was to see the revenge that we taught, that we'd done there. They produced that, they choreographed it, the costume, that they'd done everything. They did the artwork, everything that you see, they really worked hard on. So the four children we want to recognise just now, who were the first to complete that particular qualification, were the first four children in North Lanarkshire to achieve a Community Achievement Award from Kelvin College, which is really quite something. So there's four children I want to give a little bit of recognition to just now, but there's also other children who have put everything through to the college and who will all graduate in the next few weeks together, all right? So I would like to recognise Emily, Zach, Cara and Luke. Robbie. will qualify, they will qualify to have for their Kelvin College award, so they will graduate along with Emily, Zach, Cara and Luke over the next few weeks. And there are a lot of children here tonight that will be enrolling on the college course in the next few weeks. And all the children you see on this stage will be given that opportunity from the age of 12. Some of the children here are just 13 and are going on to do the equivalent of a higher and an HNC, which is amazing. So, Gail, before I pass you...
She's gone.
She's gone? Yeah. Right, okay, you've got enough. Before I pass you, but the children, have you got anything you'd like to say?
They were amazing.
No, they're amazing. Thank you, Gail. I'm just because I can't see who's all going to be guests. So I don't know what's coming next, guys, but...
I'm going next.
Maybe.
Okay. I'm just going to be really, really, really fast, but I'd like to say a massive thank you on behalf of myself, Lindsay, everybody, all the kids, to Shannon. Because we'll be here with our camera time. And Emily's got a big bouquet. And I think the Abbey's got one as well, and a massive card, the biggest card we can find. We've absolutely loved doing this show, and obviously we couldn't do it without Sharon creating it and just doing absolutely everything, getting the wonderful costumes and doing everything. So can we give her a huge thank you? Thank you so much.
Alright, first of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming tonight. It's been a pleasure being on the stage act once again. I'm a bit disappointed, I'm a bit nervous. But, I'd like to congratulate the people that did their Community Achievement Awards, and I'd like to thank Gail for giving us the opportunity for that. The little kids that also performed in the senior production, because they did fantastic. And all the enthusiasm down in that, oh my god, it's fantastic. And we Owen, where is he?
Owen.
That pure dance at the end, that was fantastic. And I'd like to see that we've all became a big troop in SK and we're all a big family. I'd like to thank Shadon for giving us these perfect roles. And that's all I've got to say.
Yeah, it's just to say, I'd like to thank again the wee children here who have just been amazing and amazing to teach and watch. And then it's obviously all thanks to Sharon, because she makes everything, pulls it all together and makes all the kids so confident and have so much fun. They're so energetic and it's just great to see them all together. But thanks, Sharon, for coming.
One more wee gift, and that's for Sam. I've promised Sam he could choose. Sorry, Sam's family, but he could choose a weapon for the battle scene. I think he chose a baseball bat. Get your baseball bat. All right.
Okay.
I just.
kind of the same as what Emily and Zach said. I just like to thank Sharon and Gail for like letting us do in the college course and just for helping with the show. And then all the wee ones were amazing, obviously, and they just made the show even better.